Hello and welcome again to the course. Before we get too deep into the lectures here, I wanted to preview the interactive hands-on labs platform called Qwiklabs and how you're actually going to be practicing a lot of the things that you're going to learn here inside of real Google Cloud Platform accounts. But you don't need your own credentials, those are actually going to be provided for you. So let's take a look at how the labs platform is set up. Inside of Coursera, you're actually going to see a lab or an item that's marked out for an external tool to open up, and you're going to click on that tool. After that, you're going to see a Start Lab button in green and a timer associated with it for you to complete the lab in that duration. After you click that Start Lab, credentials for your student accounts are automatically going to be provided to you in a new box that's going to pop up. In addition, there's going to be another button that says Open Google Console in yellow. And once you open that up, that's going to ask you to log into the Google Cloud Platform with the key caveat that you're logging in with a student account and not your own personal account should you already have one set up. And last but not least, we'll do a few demos and walkthroughs of what the UI looks like. So let's take a look. So inside an example Coursera course, you're going to come across a lab that looks something like this. This is just an example. This is lab zero, but it could be any of the labs that you might find. Once you've clicked on that, you'll see a checkbox that's going to authorize the lab to run, and you accept the terms and conditions for Coursera, and you click on Open Tool. And once you click Open Tool, that's going to bring you to the Qwiklabs environment. And a couple of key things to notice here. On the right-hand side is your instructions pane for the actual lab. Now, this lab is a meta lab. It's all about Qwiklabs in general. But whatever your course is, this is where the instructions for completing the lab are going to take place. So you always want to keep this prompt open. Now, once you actually click Start Lab, a provisioned instance of the Google Cloud Platform, complete with any additional instances, or say you're working with VMs, if there's something that the lab provider wanted you to have, it's actually going to be created inside of this lab instance for you, which is great. It's a sandbox instance. Now, once you notice I click Start Lab, I have 15 minutes to complete this lab. I promise you that the timers are going to be associated with additional padding for the labs that you're going to do. This isn't going to get to take us 15 minutes. This will take us maybe about 5 minutes. So now, as I mentioned before, you have the username and password and a project ID. What I'll ask you to do now is click on Open Google Console. And once you've opened Google Console, you'll be asked to sign in with your email. Now, the key thing here is if you use Google Resources before, immediately you'll start typing in your personal email. I do it all the time. Make sure you go back to your lab credentials screen and copy and paste the username that's auto-generated for you. This is going to be unique for you, and it's actually going to be unique for every lab that you run. So you'll be creating a new student account for each lab that you run. Copy and paste that password, which is going to be different from mine, so don't worry about copying that down. Click Next in your browser. Paste in that password, accept the terms. Don't worry about setting up a secondary phone number. Accept the terms of the Google Cloud Platform. And once you see a screen that looks like this, then you're good to go. Make sure, a key tidbit, is this is your project selector. It should be this auto-generated Qwiklabs alphanumeric. If you should happen to see something that says either select a project, or if you see something that says Qwiklabs Resources, you actually want to click on this and make sure to select your alphanumeric Qwiklabs ID and then go ahead and hit open. Once you're within here, you're good to go. So follow the instructions for the rest of the lab. It's going to guide you through what products and services that you're going to be working with. You can access the menu of products and services in the upper left-hand corner here, or if it's a lab that's working with Cloud Shell, all the way up here is the button to activate Cloud Shell, which will bring open that terminal instance for Google Cloud Platform. Last few things. Back here, you'll see that our timer is automatically running still. Once you're completed with the lab, you're done with it, or if you wanted to take another attempt at the lab, you have upwards of 3 attempts per lab, which is great. So say you wanted to run through the lab very quickly the first time and then experiment and explore with it the second time, you're welcome to do that for a couple of times. Now make sure in order to get your completion stats properly recorded, click on End Lab. You'll be faced with a prompt that says, "Are you all done?" Once you click End Lab, your project, any data sets, anything that you've been working with inside of this sandbox project is going to be deleted. So make sure if you have any queries that you're running or any interesting notes that you have saved inside of your Google Cloud Platform Qwiklabs account, that you copy and paste those and save them somewhere else, perhaps in your own personal Google Cloud Platform account or somewhere locally on your machine. And once you've clicked End Lab, then you can enter feedback for the lab and you can continue moving on with the rest of the courses in Coursera. So again, quick recap. The number one key things to remember is click on Open Tool. That'll open up Qwiklabs. The second is, in order to get those credentials here on the left-hand side, you have to click Start Lab, which again kicks off the timer. And there's no way to pause once the lab is started. But again, keep in mind, you have multiple attempts. And lastly, click on End Lab when you're ready to complete out the lab that you've been working on. That's it. Good luck with the labs that come later on, and enjoy the course.